Hey photographers, and in this video we're going to go over how to create your own packages or how to create your own favorites in School Prints Rose. I recorded this video before, but this is an updated version for 2018. School Prints by Nations Photo Lab helps photographers succeed in the volume photography market. I want to thank you for taking the time to join us in this video and look forward to hearing any feedback that you might have. You're now looking at School Prints Rose. If you haven't downloaded School Prints Rose already, head on over to schoolprints.com and click on the green download button. Let's go ahead and start making some packages. Right now I'm on my home screen. Here's where you would enter your account number and your password and log in. But let's go right ahead to start ordering. You'd select the catalog. Now, if you've determined that you want us to do color corrections and have our professional lab techs color correct your images, then I would suggest clicking this drop down menu here and selecting luster color adjusted. And if you do not wish to have us color correct your images, then go ahead and select luster non-color adjusted. Okay, once you've selected your catalog, you're now looking at the tab called units right here. If you can see my mouse. And the first thing we want to do is find what I would call our anchor product. So let's say that you have your order form or you know your packages, package A, B, C, whatever you would call your packages. You would start to create them by selecting what I was referring to earlier as an anchor product, which typically is an 8x10. This is the first product that you would add to your package. And you can see I've clicked on the 8x10 icon, and then my 8x10 template pops up in the middle of the screen here in Rose. The next step, and the most important step, is to activate the package creator. When I hover my mouse, you can see that it reads activate package creator. Make sure you click on that. How do you know this has been activated? Well, once you clicked on it, this little menu here will pop up. So let me do that again. You can watch one more time. Deactivated, activated. So the next step would be to continue to build the package. Now, I've seen a lot of photographers and customers make this mistake. They'll start to build the package, and instead of clicking and dragging the template, they will just click the template, and that can be really frustrating. So just a quick reminder that if you don't drag and drop, then you're gonna have to start over. So let me see, you can see that I've done that accidentally here with the 5x7 and two 3.5x5s. Let me bring my 8x10 back. That's the only time that you're gonna click. Every other time you click and drag. So let's go ahead and create my first package. As you can see, I've left-click dragged four 4x5s. These are all sheets. So keep in mind, everything that you see in the units section here is considered a sheet or a unit. And we print on 10-inch paper, which means we're going to be able to fit any of the configurations on a 10-inch sheet of photo paper, Kodak Endura professional photo paper. For example, an 8x10, four 4x5s up on a sheet of an 8x10. 8 wallets, which I'll go ahead and add to the package, which is actually printed on a 7x10 because each wallet is 2.5 by 3.5. So far I have my basic package built here. I have an 8x10, 4 4x5s on a sheet, and 8 wallets on one sheet. The price on these, as a reminder, is 87 cents per sheet in the non-color adjusted catalog. If you were ordering in the color adjusted catalog, the pricing would be $1.12. Let's go ahead and add one more unit to my package. I'm going to go ahead and add the 5x7 with two 3.5x5s. Drag and drop. Edit that out. Okay, you can see now that I have four units here. So we're going to start with a real basic package, and then I'm sure there would be a lot of questions you're asking yourself right now, such as quantities would be one that always comes to mind. Maybe different products, mixing the catalogs, and we'll get into that, but right now let's just go ahead and take a look at how to create a basic package first and get the foundation for doing this. Now, once you've done this, it'll become very easy, and also the best part is that once you've saved them, they're there for you every time you use the program. You don't have to create these every single time. Alright, so now I've created my package. The next step is to click this heart with the plus sign, which is saving this as a new favorite product. Once I've clicked on that, you can see I've already done a lot of other packages here, but you can see that I have a blinking cursor, so I'm going to go ahead and name my package. So let's call this demo 1. Of course, you can call it whatever you want. And that's how easy it is to create a package. In the next video, we're going to show you a few more tips and tricks on how to create more specific packages with quantities mixed with products, and just a few more tips and tricks to make sure that you fully understand how to create your own favorites and packages within School Prints Rose. Hope you've enjoyed this video, and thank you so much for tuning in.